Hello, Mitchell here. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to the Bill Nell Art Show. And today I'm introducing episode 2 of our YouTube show. Now today Bill is going to be painting a wonderful painting for everyone using somewhat of an unorthodox method. Now, you know, the greatest artists in life sometimes don't always use the most conventional, specified, common tools to see their vision come to life and take place. They can use other methods, any methods they can, to create life to their art. And you'll see what I mean by that today. If you have any comments or questions or just want to say hey, leave it in the comments section below. And please like and subscribe to our channel, and we thank you so much.
Today, we start a new painting. I'm putting a little liquid white on my canvas. We're doing a wet on wet again. I think we'll do a little, maybe a winter scene, mountains. Everybody likes barns, so we'll do a little barn. So, it has inspired me to do, we got the lamp black. Put a little of that right there. Use a little Indian yellow in my sky. So I'll just put a little of that on the palette. Today we'll use Persian blue. I got a little blue on my brush, using a 2-inch brush. And I'm just gonna make some clouds. I'll take the tip of the brush. I'll just make little circles. We're not too worried about detail right now. We're just blending. Maybe it's a big sky day, big Montana sky day. Yeah, like that. I'll show you. Paint these edges. That way, these little paintings, you're going to have to, if you just want to, you're going to have to buy a frame. Makes it nice. Think about the small paintings, everybody's got a little place for them, you know, in your home. The bigger ones now require a better location. You got to give it a little more thought, in other words. Say, well, I made a mistake. There's no mistakes in painting. It's just happy inspiration. Now, yellow you gotta be careful with, because you know what you get with yellow and blue, right? You'll get green. So you wanna kinda keep it somewhat separate. I think we need a touch of crimson red in here. Alright, I'm just going to pull a little red out here. And put a touch of titanium white in there. Blend those together. You see, it kind of makes a purple. You add just a touch of blue. See that? You kind of got to remember where the sun is. The sun is fixing to go down. So. As it goes down, it makes these beautiful little highlights. So we'll add these right in here. Like that. I'm just making a little small circle. I'm dragging my brush this way though, because across like that, we've all seen the sunsets, you know, and they go to length. See how nice that is? Not so much up here, but down here at the bottom, like that. Yeah. I'm going to use that blue again. And I'm going to darken a few areas And again, I'm going to just do little circles with it, with a small brush. And it gives a little contrast. But when we start our blending, then it'll start looking a lot nicer. And I still got a lot of paint on this brush, so I'll kind of drag it. And you'll pick up, as you do more of this, you'll pick up little techniques and ideas. But basically what we're doing is you're training your eye to what exactly am I looking at here? Sky. And I'm going to add some darker colors up here because the sky gets a little darker when the sun goes down. If you notice, it gets a little darker at the top. And I'm going to put a little in here. Now I'm going to take a touch of this black. This is lamb black. We're going to make some really dark areas up in here. The contrast of the black really makes the lighter colors look nicer. And then I'll just add a few circles in here. Alright, now I'm going to take a dry 2-inch brush and just do a little blending. I'll take the corner of my brush and I'll make little circles and drag it. That's what I'm doing. Briefly, and just pull it. Just pulling it. Circles back and forth, strokes, and I'll change to the other side of the brush. Get some of this red in here. And it starts looking like clouds. See how nice that looks on the canvas? And I'll go back and forth. Now you notice I stayed out with black and do it last. It's going to coat my brush a little more. So you want to do the light, blend the lighter colors first, then the darker colors. And I'll use the same brush. And I'll coat them. I'm just making small circles. Just pulling it. Now that. Let me see here. And if I see an area I don't like, then I'll go back over it. Because you're going to run into that. You're going to say, well, you might get finished with the sky, so you know, I don't really like that. But, not to worry. And we're going to do a few clouds here. I'm making just small little circles. Yeah. Big ones. And I get some more paint. But the little bee circles, the white looks nice against the darker areas. Gives a lot of contrast. You can see how this. Get down here in some of these blues. Yeah. I'll put them in here. It might use a little more red. I'll change up as I go. Well, maybe need a little more red in here. But you can see this little line, a little sun line right in here. And if you notice, I'm going this way with my paint because that's the sun goes down, it's going over the horizon. My mind, I painted a painting yesterday, and it was a, I call it open range. And it was a barn with a hill in the background. Basically, I'm doing the same one, just doing it again. Sometimes I had to paint the same fellow painting. I have the same person wants another one. Exactly, so I have done that. Notice I got a little hair on there. I'll just take my brush, flip it off. Kind of drag your palette knife over the canvas. You remember you already got white on there as well. And we're going to make it a little, look a little ski slope here. But you notice, going back over and just pulling lightly here. I like those ridges that left right there, if you can see those. You have some interesting thing happen by accident sometimes. And you say, oh, I like that, I'm gonna leave that. And if you want, you can take your brush and smooth out the bottom part. I'll show you how to do that. And I just want to kind of drag it in. I'm just blending again. I'm gonna leave that top. I like the way that looks. But I'm pulling this bottom, make it look like a snowbank. Then again, I'll get the sides and get to the bottom. How do you like that? I like how that blends in. Once painted, blend that a little more. I'm just doing little circles here. Pretty neat doing it. Little snow clouds up in here. Yeah, I like that. Where do we want the barn? Let's use some Van Dyke brown. I would like my barn right about here. So what I'm going to do is scrape some of this paint off. I'm going to place the barn. Just want to scrape out where the barn's going here. There it is. Snow. Today we had a good snow. Oh, we will start the barn right about here. And once again, all I'm doing is dragging my palette knife. You see how let it pull. Get you a touch of that. You just drag it and let it pull. It makes it interesting. Group. Taking the edge of that palette knife and putting a little snow in the barn. Hey, like that. And then we're gonna do the boards. I'm just pulling them down like that. Isn't that pretty neat? Pretty easy too. See those streaks in there? Did it mixing the paint. It kind of looks like boards, don't it? Looks like old rustic boards. I actually use a grate to make frames with it, some of the old barn boards. And I'll do the sides. Here are the sides. And I'll clean it up a little bit. Need a little bit up in here. And a little bit right there. And that's... I'm going to add a little snow up here. I'll just pull a little snow on this side. We had a pretty good snow the other day. That's Friday. Got several inches of snow. It didn't last too long. About all gone, I think. My daughter, she got her master's degree last Friday. We couldn't get postponed until Saturday. Now, we want to do make a barn door, so I'm going to just use some of this lamp black and get a little on there on the edge. We'll make the barn opening right about here. All we're doing is pulling. And you can add a little hay loft up in here. Put a little burnt sienna on this. Mix just a touch of white with it. I'm going to add some boards in here. Makes a nice technique. And I'll take the, you can paint a barn pretty fast. You had to put every little line in with a brush, it would take you a lot longer. But you can see how nice that works. A little black, I'm going to make the roof line here. I just pull this down. It kind of outlines this roof up here a little bit. Have a steady hand to do this. So when you're doing trees, works to your advantage. I got the black on there. I'm just gonna pull some in the snow. Just pulling lightly in the snow. It'll show where that bank was. Make a little path here. I'll just go up here. Once again, I'm just pulling. I'm gonna pull it all the way out here. And make the path go back this way. Got another. Snow right in here. We'll pull this down. Another bank of snow. And you gotta just remember your direction. You wanna pull it the same direction. When you notice snow, it flows, the wind moves it, you know. Get more white on here. Yeah, I like that effect there. I like how that's blending out there. Maybe this is a road that goes up to the house here. Or the barn. The house you really can't see. But you can see how nice that's coming up. And the whole time I just used a palette knife. Kind of outlined where the driveway is. Just using the very edge. interesting things just by experimenting sometimes. Then, if I don't like it, I can change it. I think I'm gonna add a little pink down in here. You know, snow, when it gets dirty, it changes colors. I grew up in Detroit. And with the cars, you get a lot of, you know, slush on the road. So we'll add some of that. Add some of this nice violet colors here. How's that? I think we'll also add us an old oak tree that's so old it's about to deteriorate here. About to fall down, limbs are falling. So I'll just use a little black, a little of my Van Dyke brown. I'll put the tree in. And all I'm gonna do is pull this over. Just doing a little movement here with my palette knife. Not too worried about what it looks like right now. This is an old tree. About to fall down. Now, go back and forth a little bit, give it a little base. Snow. So we just put it on this knife and just add a little snow. Sometimes I'll take my palette knife and I'll just do that. Be some more white on here. Pull this over. Like that. That's cool. I like that. Clean up some of these limbs here. Just put them, get a little bit of paint on my palette knife. As it, we'll continue it over here. We might have some cattle in there. We don't want them to get out. We might have some black Angus in there. We're gonna kill the fatty calf for the holidays. Remember. remember it snowed, so we want a little snow. Got too much white hair. Just put a touch of snow on the fence. This line. And just drawing an edge here for the hill. Using the very tip of my palette knife. Almost like a brush. Not too worried. But just giving the fence post a place to sit, pretty much is what you're doing. Take some more white. I think we got some snow up in here. I had that black underneath, so once I put that white on there, well, it makes it pop, you know? I'm gonna add some red in here. Just dragging my brush. Give this robe a little character here. There we go. Dragging it. Dragging it out. I need some red in here. Actually, the black gives it more contrast. Black in there, it gives a lot more contrast. As I said before, you be careful with your angles, because palette knife again. We'll put in some brush right in here. I'm just scraping the canvas. All I'm doing, put a few twigs, whatnot, in here. We'll put some back in here now. In the back area, just make them a little smaller, so you don't see them as much, you know. They show up around the barn a lot. Maybe some weed eating, looks like. I'm doing is scratching. If you want, you can even put some chickens in there. I had a lady that, she had chickens. I did a painting for her. People love put a little snow. Made it personal, you know? It made her painting then. She would say, well, he put my chickens in there. They were pretty cute. And I think we're gonna call that one done. I'll put it over here. Make it very small. I have to look for it here. There you go, finish.